Isaac Newton was the man behind discovering and explaining one of the most important laws of our planet. And I don't mean laws like things you can and cannot do. I mean a law that explains a part of how we live our lives on Earth. But don't worry, I'll explain that in a few moments.
First, we need to tell you a bit about him. Like, he has two birthdays.
Isaac Newton was officially born on the 4th of January in the year 1643. But this is because back in the 17th century, when Isaac Newton was born, they used a different calendar than we use today.
Today, we use the Gregorian calendar. But when Isaac Newton was born, it was called the Julian calendar. And for years, people believed he was born on Christmas Day, December 25th, in the year 1642.
One thing we do know for sure is where he was born. Isaac Newton was born in Woolsthorpe, United Kingdom. His father was a farmer also named Isaac Newton, but unfortunately he died 3 months before Isaac Newton's birth.
Isaac's mother remarried when Isaac was 3 years old and left young Isaac in the care of his grandparents.
And as he grew up, Isaac Newton loved school and his favorite subject was chemistry.
However, due to family circumstances, Isaac had to leave school at the age of 12 so he could help out on the family farm. However, Isaac had other plans. He had no interest in becoming a farmer and soon went back to school.
Later in 1661, Isaac began to attend college at Cambridge. He spent much of his life at Cambridge and became a professor of mathematics and a fellow of the Royal Society, a group of scientists in England.
Isaac Newton was eventually elected to represent Cambridge University as a member of Parliament.
After Isaac Newton graduated from college, he returned to his family's farm, but he continued to study and do experiments on his own. Early in his career, Isaac Newton discovered that when white light passes through a prism or triangular piece of glass, it breaks up into a band of colors. Isaac Newton concluded that white light is actually a mixture of colors.
Okay, but wait. I heard that an apple landed on his head and that's how he discovered...
Wait. That's one of the most talked about subjects regarding Newton. The apple that supposedly fell on his head when he was sitting under an apple tree one day.
Oh.
However, this is actually a bit of a lie. Isaac Newton only witnessed an apple falling from a tree one day. And that was what got him thinking about what really caused the apple to fall to the ground.
Isaac Newton later developed his theory of gravity, believing that Earth has a force that pulls objects down, which prevents objects from aimlessly floating around. And that is the law of gravity, and we have a video all about it. We'll link it below in the description.
Isaac Newton also discovered many important scientific things that we still use today.
He studied motion, which is how things move. He came up with three laws about motion that are still important today.
His first law says that objects want to keep doing what they are already doing. His second law said that force equals mass times acceleration. And his third law said that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. And these laws help explain how things move.
Isaac Newton also invented calculus, a special type of math, and he built the first reflecting telescope which helped him study space.
Did you know about his brother?
No.
His brother Fig?
No.
What's his name?
Fig.
Fig what?
Newton.
What's his whole name?
Fig Newton.
That's not his brother, haha, but you fell for it!
Anyways, a reflective telescope is a type of telescope that uses mirrors to reflect light from an image. Nearly all of the major telescopes used in astronomy today are reflective telescopes.
Isaac Newton died on March 31st, 1727. He was 84 years old, which is considered very old for the time period.
After his death, an examination was done to Isaac's body, and it was found that his hair contained traces of mercury, which suggested he might have died from mercury poisoning, which was probably because of experiments that he was conducting.
Isaac Newton is buried in Westminster Abbey, alongside other scientists like Charles Darwin.
Well, hey, guess what? Now we all know just a little bit more about Sir Isaac Newton.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel.
It sure does.
Make sure you subscribe.